Bonjour tout le monde. Right now, a lot of people are sitting around the kitchen table with bills, trying to figure out what needs to be paid and how to plan for the coming months. If you've been laid off, had your hours reduced, or are worried about your industry, these might be really stressful decisions. Far too many Canadians are having these tough conversations about finances and their future. Just look at the numbers. Last week, almost 1 million people applied for employment insurance. The hard truth is that people are out of work because of this crisis and worried about what comes next. So I want you to know that we'll be there to help you. Our government is doing everything we can to be there for you. Tôt ce matin, la Chambre des communes a adopté un projet de loi d'urgence pour aider les gens le plus rapidement possible. Le projet de loi est maintenant devant le Sénat. J'espère que son adoption va se faire rapidement pour qu'on puisse aider les Canadiens dès que possible. On aura plus de détails pour vous cette semaine et d'autres mesures à annoncer. Et ce n'est qu'un début. Mais cette nouvelle loi nous permet de prendre les mesures nécessaires pour vous appuyer tout de suite. On va notamment bonifier l'allocation canadienne pour enfants et reporter de 6 mois la date de remboursement des prêts et bourses étudiants. Et surtout, avec cette loi, on introduit la nouvelle prestation canadienne d'urgence. Cette allocation remplacera les deux allocations qu'on a annoncées la semaine dernière, soit l'allocation de soins d'urgence et l'allocation de soutien d'urgence, pour simplifier le processus. Comme je l'ai dit depuis le début, à mesure que la situation évolue, on s'ajuste pour mieux vous aider. La prestation canadienne d'urgence donne 2 000 $ tous les mois pour les prochains 4 mois aux travailleurs qui sont privés de leur chèque de paie à cause de la COVID-19. Donc, si vous avez perdu votre emploi, que vous travaillez à temps plein ou à contrat, ou que vous soyez travailleur autonome, cette prestation est là pour vous. Si vous êtes malade ou en quarantaine, ou si vous prenez soin de quelqu'un qui a la COVID-19, cette prestation est là pour vous. Si vous devez rester à la maison sans toucher de salaire pour prendre soin de vos enfants ou de vos aînés, cette prestation est là pour vous. Et même si vous avez encore un emploi, mais que vous ne recevez pas de rémunération à cause de cette crise, la nouvelle prestation canadienne d'urgence est là pour vous. Un portail en ligne pour soumettre les demandes sera lancé le plus rapidement possible. Et les gens commenceront à recevoir de l'argent dans les 10 jours après avoir présenté leur demande. The Canada Emergency Response Benefit will provide $2,000 a month for the next 4 months for workers who lose their income as a result of COVID-19. This will replace the 2 benefits we announced last week, the Emergency Care Benefit and the Emergency Support Benefit, in order to streamline the process. Like I said from the start, we will adapt our approach wherever needed. If you've lost your job because of COVID-19, whether you're full-time, contract, or self-employed, this new benefit will be there for you. If you're sick or quarantined, looking after someone sick, or at home taking care of your kids, it's there for you. And even if you're still employed but not receiving income because of this crisis, the CERB is there for you. An application portal will launch as quickly as possible, and people should start receiving money within 10 days of applying. I know people are concerned about delays. Families are worried about when they'll get help. It can be hard to get through on the line, and that is frustrating. Public servants are working around the clock while dealing with unprecedented demand and all of the same personal stress everyone else is facing. They will get to your application. Help is on the way. In order to speed things up, we're rapidly deploying workers from different departments to deal with claims. In the last 10 days, we've boosted the team by close to 13,000 people to take your calls, process your claims, and get you the support you need. And since last Monday, we've already processed 143,000 employment insurance claims. That means more money will go directly to people right across the country. We're working to get you the support you need when you need it. And if you're doing okay, there's a way you can help someone else, as an employer, a landlord, or even just a friend, so you can be part of the solution. It can make all the difference, because it's by working together that we'll get through this. And our team knows that. We're collaborating with the provinces and territories, as well as with First Nations, Inuit, and Métis Nation communities to coordinate our efforts and ensure that everyone is supported. Earlier this week, with the premiers, we also discussed testing for COVID-19. We know that how long you wait for your results varies widely. The premiers and I know we need to address that, and we are. This is something Minister Haidu and I discuss with officials every day, and we'll continue doing what's needed to speed up results for everyone. But I also want to recognize the incredible work medical professionals are doing on this front. According to Dr. Tam, we're now testing about 10,000 people a day. That's a huge increase in numbers in a very short period of time. And it's because people across the country are working tirelessly to make it happen. At the same time, we're helping companies, labs, and scientific institutions produce and supply what we need most, from masks and ventilators to vaccines and antiviral drugs. We're collaborating with airlines to get Canadians home from abroad and instructing everyone that they must isolate at home for 14 days. We're also working with our international partners on this crisis. This morning, I had calls with President Sall of Senegal and President Kagame of Rwanda to share strategies on keeping people safe and addressing the economic impacts of this pandemic. I've also spoken to Prime Minister Abiy of Ethiopia and President Kenyatta of Kenya about international coordination. And tomorrow, I'll be speaking with other G20 leaders to discuss further global coordination to our response. Plus que jamais, c'est absolument essentiel que les Canadiens aient accès aux dernières informations. Mais comme tout le monde, les médias ressentent eux aussi les conséquences du virus. Pour faire en sorte que les journalistes puissent continuer à faire leur travail, qui est encore plus essentiel en temps de crise, notre gouvernement annonce aujourd'hui des mesures pour les appuyer. Le ministre Guilbeault donnera plus de détails tantôt. Mais en attendant, je tiens à remercier tous les journalistes et nos médias canadiens qui gardent les Canadiens au courant des derniers développements avec des faits et des informations fiables. On apprécie énormément votre travail. Right now, it's more important than ever that Canadians have access to the latest news and information. To ensure that journalists can continue to do this vital work, our government is announcing new measures to support them. Minister Guilbeault will have more to say about this shortly, but I want to take a moment to thank our journalists and media for everything they do, today and every day. Above all, the most important way we can work together is by staying apart. Social distancing is our best tool to stop people from getting sick. I know people are seeing different graphs about how effective social distancing can be and new maps tracking the spread of this virus. Every time you turn on the TV or go online, you probably read something new. I know I do. And you'll want to know what's coming next. Today, I'll be getting the latest modeling from the Public Health Agency of Canada, and we'll discuss how to share this information even more directly with all of you. But you deserve the best information we've got about what's happening today and what tomorrow might bring. Because otherwise, the uncertainty can be really tough, not just for your routine, but for your mental health, too. We're facing a once-in-a-generation challenge, and on top of that, you can't do many of the things that keep you feeling good, getting together with friends or having dinner with your neighbor. If you need help, reach out to your neighbor, to a sibling, to a friend, to a hotline. But do it from home. Don't go out unless you absolutely have to. If you're already following these rules, thank you for doing your part. If you aren't, know that you're making a dangerous choice. Because ignoring these rules puts every single one of us, yourself included, at risk. Voici la réalité. Si les gens refusent de suivre les recommandations, nos médecins et nos infirmières ont plus de chances de contracter la COVID-19. Et si nos professionnels de la santé tombent malades, ils ne peuvent pas aller travailler. Et donc, ils ne peuvent pas vous soigner si vous tombez malade. Notre pays fait face à la plus grande crise de santé publique de son histoire. Nous ne pouvons pas mettre à risque les gens qui nous gardent en santé. Et ceux qui s'obstinent à voir leurs amis ou à recevoir des gens à souper mettent tout le monde en danger. Les épiciers, les techniciens d'électricité, les chauffeurs d'autobus, les agriculteurs, les éboueurs méritent mieux que ça. On doit les protéger. C'est pas compliqué, ce qu'on vous demande. Restez chez vous. Si vous devez absolument sortir, gardez une distance de 2 mètres les uns des autres. Et si vous revenez d'un séjour à l'étranger, rentrez directement chez vous et restez là pendant au moins 14 jours. Ça s'applique à tout le monde. Pour passer à travers, on doit tous veiller les uns sur les autres et on doit tous faire notre part. Je sais qu'on peut y arriver. Je sais que les Canadiens sont à la hauteur de la situation. Merci.